morning, boys and girls. It's Saturday the 15th of April 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. I don't know how many of you there be out there today, actually. I expect lots of people will be on their little holidays, although it's a bit cheap. Not cheap, that's me. I'm the one who's cheap, dear, not the day. It's a bit chilly outside. Not as chilly as it was yesterday, I must say. Oh, dare I tell you, I had to flick the heating on last night twice. Once before I went out to work, and once when I left the timer on last night because I thought, oh, it's decidedly chilly, and it happened all of a sudden. Did you notice that? It was just after 3 o'clock when I was at church. Anyway, had a nice day yesterday. After I finished the show, I jumped on my bike and I went down to the bank. Of course, it was closed yesterday, being a bank and a bank holiday. Of course, Good Friday. So I popped down to the bank yesterday, put some money in the machine, and the lady in front of me, I could see she was struggling a bit. Now, I'm always very wary to sort of try and perhaps talk to someone who's at one of those machines. Do you know what I mean? Because you kind of think to yourself, oh, you know, are you going to frighten them? Perhaps they think they're going to be banged over the head and had their purse grabbed or something like that. But she eventually turned around and I says, you're right there, love. And she turned around and she says, can you see this number on the card? She says, I can't see it. And you know, at the end of your bank card that you have to put in the machine, they've got those embossed numbers, haven't they, that are raised. And it was either a 6 or an 8, and we couldn't work out what it was. Oh, I think we went for the 8 eventually, and it did work, whatever she was doing with her machine. Because that's the other thing. I always turn around. If I'm the next one in the queue, sort of just two people at the machine, I turn around because I think it's, you know, to show some sort of consideration for the other person at the machine. Unlike the, you know, one of the people behind you, sometimes they're sitting there and you can hear them tutting because you're doing a few different things. They're tutting and they try and look over your shoulder, nosy bastards. Don't be looking at my numbers, my love. I change them every week. I change my numbers. I've no idea what they are half the time. No idea. So there we are. I did my good deed of the day. I helped her, and then while she was tapping in her things, I quickly grabbed her handbag and ran down the street with it. Not really. Oh, better ring the police now. Did you hear what you just said? Don't be so stupid. Stupid people who don't get comedy. Go away. Don't want you on here, lovey. Bye. So that was the bank. I then went up and I collected my new picture. Now, have you noticed anything new in the studio today? Anything at all? Anything? Is there anything new in the studio? Oh, could that be the new picture on the wall? Look at this. Isn't that lovely? Now, this I bought on eBay a little while ago for about £30. And it's by an unknown artist, you know, who does paintings, I suppose, and wants to make himself or herself, I don't know, a bit of money on the out of their talent. And they sold it on eBay. And I came across this and I bought it. It's signed at the bottom there. I'm not sure. I'm sure they were from Poland or somewhere like that. And, of course, there's a picture of Big Ben there. You've got that beautiful old lamp thing there. The Houses of Parliament, someone standing. That would be the river there, you see, that's the river. So that would be on the, that would be the bridge where the terrorists and the woman jumped over there. Do you remember that? She died, you know. The woman who died in the Thames, that jumped in the Thames when that terrorist attack was happening, actually died. I don't know what she died of. See, I don't think the Thames is a particularly clean water. You know, so if you don't get done by drowning, you'll get some sort of terrible disease in there or something like that, I suppose. I don't know what she died from. Anyway, so that's the picture. And it's been very well done. It arrived in like a tube, all sort of wound up, you know. And I took it down. It's been sitting in my living room for almost a year, waiting to go down the framers. Anyway, I took it down the framers, and I've had it done there. And it's a good job, but I mean, 120 quid, dear. 120 quid they charged me for this, look, to put that on the frame. It's a lot of money, isn't it? Of course, I told my sister last night this on the phone. Oh, well, you should have told me. Lee does those. What do you mean Lee does those? Oh, it's a friend of Martin, my brother-in-law. Oh, well, you didn't tell me that, did you? How annoying is that? How many times does that happen to you? You know, you've done something, bought something, gone somewhere, and then someone comes up to you and says, oh, you should have told me. I know someone that would do that for half the price. Oh, dear. Oh, well, we move on. So I've got that. So it's like all very nice. On the way, dropped that back in the car. When I had my hair cut, got to look nice and sharp for my sister. Because if I don't look as sharp as possible, my niece, and actually it's only one nephew who does it, actually. Jimmy, the 20-year-old, and my niece, 30-year-old. If there's any faults, they are very, very quick to point them out. Oh, hello, Chris. Oh, haven't you put on weight? Oh, hello, Chris. Haven't you got a bit balder? Oh, hello, Chris. Why have you turned up with one eye? You know, and stuff like that. Aren't they wonderful children? And any comments like this, if either of you are watching the show today, any comments like that will be, of course, reflected in this year's Christmas gift. So be very careful. Very careful. More about my nephew in a minute. Cheeky little bastard he is. I'm telling you, I'm coming to that in a minute. So I did that in the hairdressers, actually where my mate had his haircut the other day. He was a bit rough with my mate, so I was ready for the bastard. I was ready for him. I was. So he said, oh, hello. There was no one else in the shop. Just me. And he got the clippers out and he started. Oh, I went like that. Oh, did you get an electric shock? Well, no, clearly not. Or I'd be dead now, wouldn't I? Did I get an electric shock? What a thing to say to someone. Did you get an electric shock? No, I'm not dead. Dear me. So I said, no, it's a bit sharp. Oh, okay. Oh, like that goes again. Then he went in his little drawer, pulled out another plastic thing with prongs on it, pushed that onto the thing. Is that all right? Yeah, that's better. Thank you. And after that, he was gentle. So you've got to tell him, dear, I'm not there to be tortured. Who wants to be tortured like that? No, thank you. I don't. I'm not into torture. Some people are into that, you know. Oh, yes, dear. Some very, very strange things go on in this world, dear. Very, very strange. They're all on the internet, lovey. Oh, there I was, you know, looking for something to do with the church the other day, and up came a torture site. Isn't that strange and strange and mysterious? It really is. No, not torturing. So that was all done very nicely. Now, in this hairdresser, he's got two fantastic things in there. One is a massive picture of London on one of his walls, and it goes right across the wall. Amazing picture. And I said, where'd you get that done? He said, oh, I had it done as a man in Wales does them for me. I said, how much was that? £400. And actually, you know, to cover an entire wall with a picture of London, £400 it was. I thought that was damn good. Beautiful picture of London. And also, on one side of his hairdressers, he's got the normal chairs, you know, like the black chairs that adults, like adult only in age, I'm afraid not in the brain. Child in the brain, adult in the age, okay? He's got one line of normal, like one, two, three, four normal chairs. And on the other side, he's got like a little children's area. And it's fantastic. I should have taken some pictures for you or maybe a little video. But he's got like a children's area, which is, and it's like half, you know? A quarter. So that half, that side, one, two, three, four chairs. Then he's got the back wall. Then he's got some seats where you are, like a waiting area near the window there. And in that quarter there, he's got three or four seats that are like unusual children's things, like a car. Now, what's there then? I can't remember now. One of them's a car and things like that. Seats that look like something a child would want to sit in it. Maybe a car, like a giraffe or something like that. And the child will sit perhaps in the car or on the giraffe. I can't remember what. I'm sure he had a car, probably not a giraffe, but I'm just making it up so you understand the sort of thing that he had there. There were three or four of these there. And that part of the hairdressers is all brightly coloured with green trees. And oh, it's fantastic what he's done in there. Absolutely fantastic. I've never seen a hairdresser's like it. And it's like 10 minutes down the road from me. Isn't that marvellous? Next time, and he's a lovely bloke, the bloke who owns it, And I think he's got two shops. He comes from Slough in the morning, and he was saying he doesn't like living in Slough. He wants to move somewhere. It is quite busy. It's a very busy place, Slough, you know? Very, very busy in there. Oh, my God, we've got a call coming in already. I haven't even opened the lines yet. Good morning, line one. Who's that calling in on line one?
You've only got three lines, dear.
Yes, and you're on line one.
Yeah, but it's not like you've got like 27. Hello,
doesn't,
darling.
Doesn't
how
make
are you?
Doesn't make any difference. You're on a line. You're on line one.
Okay. Okay. All
would
right.
you like?
Well,
would
I'm
you like to?
To
would you like to? If
a
I can,
very,
can just
very
get
very
shut up.
Easter.
Shut up. Remember, I've got a button here.
You know, Easter is
button
also called...
down. Remember, they don't know who you are. Would you like to announce yourself?
Hello, I'm speaking. I'm speaking. I'm just ringing to wish you a very, very happy Easter.
Yes.
Are you still there?
Yes, just.
Which is also called Pascha or the Resurrection Sunday. It's a festival or a holiday celebrating the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, as described in the New Testament.
Thank you.
So I'm just wishing everybody a very happy Easter. And where are all of my Easter eggs?
You've got no Easter eggs. Would you just like to explain who you are? Because people have got no idea. The millions
everybody
of people that call into... Sorry?
Everybody knows who I am.
They don't know who you are, dear. Would
Hello?
You like to announce yourself?
Well, normally you announce me as it's my best friend, Ron.
Right, thank you. Well, you've done it now, haven't you? Well done.
Good morning.
Good morning. Would
you,
we're
how
just,
are you?
Were you? Did you just hear anything of what I was just saying?
No, I just wanted to ring up and because I just saw something on Easter and I thought, oh my God, Chris is doing his show, so I'm going to show my support and ring up and tell him about Easter.
Well, I was just telling them about that excellent new hairdressers that we've just discovered. Incidentally, I went there and had my hair cut there yesterday. He was a bit rough, so I told him, and then he was gentle after that, lovey.
Yeah. He's actually marked my face.
Oh, has he? Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, what's...
Yeah, got the, it looks a little bit sore where he's pushed a... I think he used like a cotton bud or something to remove something, some sort of mark.
Right.
And it's actually made it quite sore. So I'm having to use some of my very expensive...
Are you still in bed?
...products. To help it get better.
Are you still in bed?
No, dear. I'm up and about.
Is the phone under your chin or something, dear?
No, dear. The phone is on my ear and by my hand.
Oh, iPhone 7, isn't it?
You're the only one that has this problem, dear.
iPhone 7, dear.
Yes. So,
now, listen. The children's area in that hairdresser's... Now, do you remember what the seats are? There's a car, isn't there?
There's a car, a motorbike, and a plane.
Ah, right, a car, a motorbike, and a plane. I thought, for some reason, I thought one of them was a giraffe.
No, dear.
I don't know why I thought one of them...
Oh, I know why you're thinking of giraffes.
Why is that, then?
First of all, you're thinking of giraffes because of your African connection, where you nearly was an African who went to
take
water.
Oh, yes. Yes, I was nearly an African wife, wasn't I?
And two, because there's a baby giraffe being born at the moment in a zoo somewhere.
Oh, is there?
It's been all over the news, yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
That's why.
I didn't know that.
That's why you probably subconsciously thought about a giraffe, dear.
I was connected through the giraffe world because of that item of news. Is it fake news? It's not fake news, is it?
No, it's factual news.
It's not fake news.
I've seen the video, the live feed from Facebook on the interweb.
Thank you very much. Now, what were we going to do today? Because I can't remember.
Well, I just need to pop out and grab a couple of Easter eggs and some...
Me too, yes.
And some other bits from my local supermarket, Waitrose. The preferred supermarket of Ronnie.
Okay, would you like me to pick you up? Sorry, everyone, we're just having a little bit of a private conversation. Would you like me to pick you up later? Because I want to try and put my bicycle in the back of the car today.
Yeah, it's not really private, though, is it? Because there's like five or six other people listening.
Millions they are, dear. Millions. I've told you time and time again.
Darling,
millions.
Not millions. We
it's
must
not
talk
five
about
or six.
This.
It's at the moment, I think, let me just check for you and I can give you an exact number, dear. One moment, please. Yes, 8 million people watching at the moment.
No, there's not 8 million. It's just 8, dear.
Anyway, thank you very much. It's been very interesting. Bye-bye. I shall pick you up at approximately, standby for information, 12:30 KWT Standard Time, plus one.
Yes, as long as you're not out too long, dear, because I need to have enough sleep this afternoon. I've been very, very tired still.
Oh, well.
Very tired. Very tired. I hope I'm not on my way out.
Well, if you are, that's the way it is, isn't it? Thank you. Bye-bye.
Oh. Don't you want to hear about my other interesting stuff?
What other interesting stuff have you got to tell anyone in the
world? Oh, if you're not interested.
Come on then. No. If you've got something interesting to say. Oh, I need to ask you. That tea bag you sent me, that you bought me back, how much was this tea bag? It's just been on holiday to New York. You bought me back a tea bag from the hotel. Look.
Yeah, about $14.
$14 for one tea bag.
So
they were very. It was very nice.
We stayed at a very posh hotel, dear. But I was ringing to tell you about my garden. In my garden, I've got tulips just come up.
Are they from Amsterdam? When it's spring again, I'll bring to you tulips from Amsterdam. La da 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 da. Do you know that song?
Shut up. Shush. I'm talking.
Yeah, but no one can hear you talking.
Also, I've got what's called a bleeding heart, and it's three times the size it was last year already. And then further down the garden, I've got a white one as well now. My garden's ever so pretty, dear. You must come and do a show when it warms up again. You must come and do a show in the Royal Botanical Gardens of Ronny Gardner. Are you yawning?
No, not me, darling, not me. Not me.
You better not be yawning while I'm talking to you on the phone.
I'm not yawning. It's a very interesting call.
Words, Christopher Reardon.
Possibly the most interesting call we've had this week.
Well, you don't really get that many calls and nobody really answers, do they?
This phone is non-stop in here. I've got lights flashing. People queuing up to come on this show, dear. Queuing up.
Really?
You've seen them all. Linda Gray from Dallas, my personal friend.
No, Linda Gray is not a personal friend. Linda Gray, she took out an injunction on you.
Linda
you
Gray,
keep
who
away.
We interviewed
keep
on this
away.
Programme. I've had Tony Blackburn call me in. We've had Nikki Friend from the Eurovision Song Contest
Tony
in
Blackburn,
this studio.
But then again, Tony Blackburn, he's not now.
How can you say that? Well, come on then. Name some DJs that you listen to today.
DJ? Oh, no, I'm not a DJ type person, am I?
Exactly. How can you say it's not now? Go on, give me a name of a now DJ.
Well, I don't know because I don't sleep with him
anymore. Well, there you go then, isn't it, eh? Tony Blackburn is now, he is then, and he is the future, dear.
I mean, I hang around with a DJ.
Oh, what one's that, darling?
You, dear.
Chris Reardon, international... Well, not much of a DJ, more of a karaoke host now. That more part of my life has almost passed. The DJ part has almost passed, and it will be passed when I decide that it's passed, and that's it.
Yes, but just like Passover, dear.
Yes.
Just like Passover, you can let it pass over you.
Yes.
But anyway,
well, thank you for calling in, and
I'll
see you later. Thank you, bye-bye.
I'll see you. You're going to pick me up at 12:30.
Yes, I'll try and pick you up about 12:30, dear.
Okay, dear. And we're not going to be out too long, though, are we?
No, we won't be out too long.
Because you know what I'm like? I get tired very easily with all of my ailments.
Yes, all your illnesses. You carry on, yes, darling. Yes. Have a look on eBay and see if you can find another pair of arms to place on yourself.
I will do. Thank you very much,
Thank
darling.
You. Goodbye.
I'll see you in a little while.
Oh,
and by the way, hello, everybody. All 8 people of you.
There's
Thank
8
you.
Million. Oh, I doubt
Bye-bye.
There's that many people now since
Thank
you started
Bye-bye.
Rabbiting away. Hey, you've lost a million viewers since you've been on. Thank you. Goodbye. There we are. Oh, dear. What an uninteresting call that was, wasn't it? God, so it's supposed to be my best mate. And you'd think he'd come out with something more interesting than that, wouldn't you, eh? Dear me. Bleeding Hearts in the Garden. I don't know. Let's say good morning to some people. Good morning to Mark Cording. Morning, Mark. Joe is with us. Sean Michael Crabtree is there. And Guillermo is there this morning. Good morning, Guillermo. I don't think I'm finding all your messages. How do I do that? Just a minute. If I don't get, I think I might have to ask someone to like the page, and then I'm able to see them once you've done that. 1 minute. Let me see if I can find them. I think I might have to ask someone now. How do I stop that? let's try. No. Can someone, I can't get it unless someone like, can someone just like the video, and then I'll be able to pick up the messages then, my darlings. Otherwise, I can't let me do it. Anyway, so I've told you about the airdress, and I'll take the camera in there and take some photos of this airdress. It's called Eden, E-D-E-N, Barbers. And it's in Bracknell, OK? Eden Barbers in Bracknell. Thank you. Heidi's liked it. I can see all your messages now. Here we go, then. Good morning to Sean. Morning on this beautiful day. It certainly is out there. Bit chilly, though. Bit chilly. I've put the cat out in the garden so she can have a bit of a walk around for a while. Morning to the lovely Charlotte Taylor. Greetings, Charlotte. Are you up at my sister's at the weekend at all? Are you up there? I don't know if you're on for a visit. Good morning to Vincent, one of our karaoke singers. Sean says he loves the picture. Isn't it beautiful? 30 quid that was. I've ordered another picture, boys and girls, from eBay. A nice, bright, colourful picture. So that should be on its way and with me next week. Not expensive either. Not expensive. And that's it, OK? We've got a phone line as well. If you want to call in this morning, I'll open the phone line. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. 020-8144-3477. So then I went swimming after I had my hair cut to get rid of all those nasty little hairs. Came back here, had some lunch. While I was out shopping, actually, I did see a little gift that I made by my sister to take up there. I like to take her up a little gift. And I saw something I thought was really nice while I was walking through Bentalls. So I might buy that for my sister. I'm a kind person like that, kind person. So I packed my bag after lunch. And then I went to church for the Good Friday service at the Corpus Christi in Wokingham. Now, the mass was for 3 o'clock. They have a car park there. And you've got to get in early. Although I was there at 2:05, I thought, well, usually on a Sunday it's okay, you know, because yellow lines and that. But you've got to be very, very careful with yellow lines during a bank holiday, because depending where you are, all different rules and regulations. It's a nightmare. Terrible. The whole yellow line thing in this country is just ridiculous, because it depends where you are. Whether or not you get fined, or you're allowed to park there, or are you not allowed, and no one seems to know. And then I typed into Google, you know, Wokingham yellow lines, and you can't find anything about it. You really can't. So I wasn't sure whether I'd be able to park in the street or not. So I got there at 5:05. There was only one other car in the car park. So I parked there, and then I had a little walk into Wokingham Town Centre. Just a quick walk in there. And I noticed a whole, because they're rebuilding some of the shops there, a whole area of shops has been knocked down and all the rubble taken away within a week. I can't believe it. Can't believe it. Ever so quick they've done that. So I'm walking up, and then I had a bit of problem with my IBS. So I popped in. So I popped into Costa Coffee just to use their toilet. And then I came back again, and it was about 2:30. And the car park was almost full up now. So I then went into the church and sat down, and the service came and went. Oh, very, very moving. If you ever go to a Good Friday service, oh, it's just very, very, very moving. Wonderful, wonderful service. And it really was nice. After that, I came home, had about an hour's sleep. Usually I have two and a half hours sleep in the afternoon. I only managed to get an hour because of the time the mass finished, and I had to get up for work. So I got up for work, left the house. Best journey ever into town. Best journey ever. Now, that journey in can take anything up to 2 hours and 10 minutes. That's the longest it's ever been, right? Average, is about 1 hour and 40 minutes. It gets much worse around the Christmas, really bad around Christmas. It's really bad from mid-November right the way through to Christmas. And then the moment Christmas comes, it dies down a bit again. But the average journey time is about 1 hour and 40 minutes, I suppose, to get to work Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays for me. Last night's journey time, thank you very much, 1 hour and 14 minutes. An hour and 14 minutes. That's not bad, is it, eh? I was so happy with that. I bounced out the car, boys and girls, into work. We did the karaoke night, an excellent karaoke night last night. Wonderful people, lots of new people, lots of lovely new singers. Mary bought me a gift. Lovely Mary. Bought me a gift of, she hasn't bought me a gift, she's given me something that was hers, but I'm not allowed to open it until Easter Day. So thank you very much for that, Mary. She said it's an egg of some sort, but you can't eat it. So I'm looking forward to having a look at that on Easter Day. Also, Graham, who's a good friend of TM. Good morning, Graham. Morning, Graham. I know you'll be watching this at some point. He bought me a little stick of chocolate, which I'm not allowed to eat till Easter Sunday. Of course not. Of course not, dear. You can trust me. It's after midnight. As soon as midnight comes, I shall eat your chocolate, probably on the way to my sister's. That's when I shall be driving up there at midnight. I gave Matt, one of the singers, a lift home because he lives in Woking. Lovely Matt. If you watch any of the karaoke streams that we do from Central Station, then you will have seen Matt. He's got the most wonderful voice and he's a nice, nice person. Such a nice person. So I gave him a lift home. I noticed all the roadworks have stopped. Thank God for that. Nothing on the M3, nothing on the M4, nothing on the A3, nothing on the M25. Blooming wonderful, dear. No roadworks. All roads are open. Yes. Marvellous. So came back home. Although if you're going on a train anywhere, different case. I think there's a lot of rail works on the train. Did you notice how I did that? From road works to rail works. Very good. There's a lot of rail works on the trains. OK, so be warned of that. Be warned of that. And that's it, really. I'm going up to my sister's later on tonight. I'll be working first and then going up to my sister's. Ronnie's moving in here. That's who you just heard on the phone, my best mate. He'll be looking after Katie the cat and good luck to him. She just made quite a lot of mess there. In fact, just before I came up, you might have seen, if you were on Facebook waiting for the show to start and it kind of started, then it stopped within a few seconds. That's because I got a waft coming up the stairs of Katie the cat. I went down and, of course, there's a mess there. So I quickly tidied that up, put it in the bin out the back there and put Katie out in the garden for her to walk around a little bit. And then came upstairs and did the thing. Where was I going with that now? Just a minute now. Yeah, so Ronnie will be coming out and looking after Katie the cat. I'll be going to work tonight and then driving up to my sister's, which is so much easier. It's so much easier driving around at night. Although, you know, I don't think it's probably not a good idea to drive around on an Easter Sunday, is it anyway? So I'll be going up there quite late. I'll be staying with my sister for two nights and then moving into my caravan. Not my caravan I've hired on Monday. And I've got that actually very cheap. I got it from the Sun holiday vouchers. I think I paid about £120 for four nights. That's good, isn't it? That's all the gas and electricity is included in that. And that'd be marvellous. If you want to have a look, Tattershall Lakes Country Park, it's called. Tattershall Lakes Country Park. Hopefully I'll be doing some videos in there. I never like to promise because, you know, we might be doing things and what have you. And the reason I'm going up there, apart from seeing my sister for the Easter period, which I'm looking forward to, and the reason I'm going up there, one of the other reasons I'm going up there is to have a dent in my car repaired. This dent, I thought it had appeared, you know, one of those, you know how you find, oh, where's that dent come from? You don't know where it's come from. But I kept something in the garage and I looked the other day and this dent is at the exact height of the item in the garage. So I have a feeling I'd done it myself. Anyway, my nephew, Jimmy, does that. That's what he does for a living. He's got his own business and he fixes car dents and does sprays and things, you know, sprayings and things like that. So he's going to do it for me. So I sent, get this right, I sent him a little text last week saying, can you give me a price for the dent so I can get your money ready? And he texted me, but a little cheeky bastard. He sent me a text back and he said, oh, well, he says, I was offering to do it free of charge, but you won't have that, will you? He's actually quite right. I wouldn't ask him to do it free of charge. But you won't have that, will you? I have done a similar job recently, which was £170. I hope that will be all right. I love it. The cheek. The damn cheek. I love it. So I'm pleased to do that. Now, he was saying to his mum, my sister, that he can't understand why I want to drive all the way to Lincolnshire to have my car fixed, what with the price of the fixing and the petrol going up and down there and staying a week in the caravan. It's probably cheaper for me to have it done down here. And he's quite right. Of course it's cheaper to have it done down here. But I want to support his business. You understand? You understand that, don't you? And that's why. And quite apart from that, I want to see my sister and all the children while I'm up there. So it kind of all works out nicely like that, doesn't it, really? So that's what I'm doing at the weekend. All right. Busy, busy, busy. I just had that, you know, those nose haircutter things. Like that. I've just done my nose and it's incredibly itchy now. I should never have done it. I've noticed that whenever you do something like that, it makes your nose itchy, doesn't it? Hello to Kevin Webster, who's with us this morning. Morning, Kevin. Shania's with us. Morning, Shania. Did you enjoy your service yesterday, your mass yesterday, darling? Very, very moving. Oh, it was and it was over so quick. And I looked at my watch and it was 4:30 when we left the church. Hour and a half. Well, I've been in there 2 hours, actually. It was so moving yesterday. It really was. Good. Oh, thank you to the people who have shared the video. That's always very much appreciated. Thank you very much for sharing the video, OK? Right. let's do some stories for you this morning. Spring clean your home in a day. Do you think you could do that? Well, Aggie, you know Aggie? Aggie, she does all the cleaning programs and all that. Here's her advice. Are you ready? First of all, you need, this is into this morning's Daily Mail. First of all, you need top tools to tackle the job. Before you start, gather your cleaning materials in a bucket so that they're easy to transport. That's what we need. Good transportation, boys and girls. Good transportation, okay? You need rubber gloves on those fingers, rubber gloves, yes. Microfiber and other cleaning cloths, a feather duster, multi-surface cleaner, floor cleaner, what's a pumice stone? Pumice stone? I don't know what that is. Pumice stone, clear vinegar, bicarbonate of soda, bleach, paper towels, a lint roller, black bin bags, a toothbrush, and a pair of old socks for dusting blinds. With a mop and a vacuum cleaner handy, you're ready to start. My God! Are you going to carry all that up the blooming stairs? You must be joking, aren't you? Before you get stuck in, she says, work from top to bottom. Start upstairs and work your way down. In each room, clean the ceiling and light fittings first with a feather duster. Feather duster. Feather duster. I must get one of those. No, I've got one. I've got one somewhere. Oh, here it is. Da-da-da-da! Oh, my God. Christ, the dust that comes off that. Oh, that is filthy. That is absolutely filthy up there. Well, she ain't right. She's right, isn't she? Hang on. Do my mirror ball as well while I'm on my mirror ball. Can't see the mirror ball at the moment, can you? There we are. That's my feather dust. Well, I will do that. I'm not going to do it while I'm sitting under it. Dear, that is... I'm going to print this off and keep this. And I'll do this one day when I'm off. Very, very important to keep your houses tidy. You don't want to have an untidy house, dear. Clean the ceilings and light fittings first with a feather duster. Vacuum carpets last. This way, any dirt you'd... I think I've got dust in my mouth. Any dirt you dislodge gets swept up later. Open the windows to allow fumes to escape. Enlist some help. Get family members to clean the house. There's no one else here. I don't suppose the cat's interested in doing any cleaning either. So here we go. 9 o'clock, it's the laundry roundup. Start by gathering up everything to go into the washing machine. Bed linen, towels, mattress toppers, bath mats, cushion covers, cuddly toys can all be washed and then dried outside. Now, mattress toppers, I wouldn't get mine in a washing machine. You must be joking. That's as thick as that. That won't go. Not mine. John Lewis mattress topper, dear. I don't think you want to put all those feathers in there, surely. Bath mats, cushion covers, cuddly toys can all be washed and then dried outside. Use lavender fragranced detergent. The scent repels... I do like lavender, don't you? Have you got any lavender in your garden? I do like lavender, I really do. Blitz the bathrooms. We're going to close phone lines now, boys and girls. Close phone lines. I've got too much to say now. One moment, that's it. Close phone lines. One minute. Here we are. Oh, hang on. I've still got it open. Just a minute. Just a minute, in case we get a rush of calls. Hang on, where's that? Quit. Done. There we are. 9:15, so 15 minutes. You're supposed to do that all that in 15 minutes, right? 15 minutes later, it's blitz the bathrooms. Tackle bathrooms first. You'll be using the harshest chemicals here, so it needs time to air after you've finished. Start in the medicine cabinet. You'll be amazed at the out-of-date items lurking there. I like that word, lurking. Do you lurk? Are you lurking there? Take everything out, wipe the shelves, and return only what you'll use. Spritz the sink, bath, and shower with multi-purpose cleaner and leave to soak. Dust and wipe walls, then clean the toilet. Spritz with multi-purpose spray and wipe down with a disposable cloth. Doing the handle first and last and seat last to prevent germ spreading. Oh, yeah, you don't want to do the inside of the toilet and then use the same cloth for everything else. Dirty. Disgusting, people. Bin the used cloth, squirt the toilet cleaner around the bowl, leave to soak next, wipe down all the surfaces you sprayed a few minutes ago. And it goes on, really. So much to do. So much to do. And that, how long is that going to take? Well, she reckons you want to spend 9:15, 10, an hour and a quarter just doing the bathroom, dear. Oh, you must be having a laugh. And 5 minutes maximum for me, dear. 5 minutes. And it goes on. Conquer your moths. It tells you how to stop the moths. Work your way down the stairs. Vacuum in the carpets, including the bits in the corner. Now, that's one thing I don't do. You know, the little bits in the corner. I don't usually bother with that. I did do it for the first time. A couple of weeks ago, funnily, of the amount of dust, and they look so clean afterwards. You know, the corners down the side of the carpet, it all gets in there. Living areas, it tells you, cooking. And honestly, I'm not being funny. I know, like, she's telling you how to do it all properly. She starts at 9 o'clock, like 9 o'clock in the morning, right? And the last thing, she finishes at 5:30. Jesus Christ, you think I've got a whole day to spend cleaning? I don't think so, dear. Blimey. A whole day. 5:30. Dust, wipe and vacuum or hallway. Clean the front door. Reward yourself with a takeaway and a well-deserved gin and tonic. Does she do this every day? She's got a sad life, hasn't she, really? Blimey. Can you just imagine that? Spending a whole day cleaning your house. Do you do that? No, thank you. Anyway, that's the news there, boys and girls. How to clean your house with Aggie in this morning's Daily Mail. Look it up, okay? All right, no more messages coming in. Oh, we've had a complaint. There's been a complaint, boys and girls. We've had a complaint here into the studios of United Kingdom Talk. I know you'll be shocked and horrified. Here it comes. Gustav writes, can I just say I hate the show being 30 minutes. By the time you do your intro chat and one or two stories, it's over. I don't mind an hour, but if you're cutting down, try it for 45 minutes. So there we are. Oh, now I think an hour. I think I get the feeling that an hour's too much for most people. I just think an hour's too much for some people to sit me there rabbiting away. Listen, who wants to listen to me for an hour? I find that difficult to believe, although we've now done 40 minutes today on the show today anyway, haven't we? Huh? Dear, dear Lee. Let's have another story here. Now, I was going to do a little story. Here we go. Do you give your children sandwiches for school? Now, I had sandwiches for a while, actually. when I went to school. I think it was it primary school I had sandwiches, because I really didn't like the food in primary school. When I went to secondary school, I went to the London Oratory School in Fulham. The school, this would be in the 70s, the school meals were fantastic in there. They really were. It was all cooked on site and wonderful, wonderful school dinners we had there. I can't think of a single day where I didn't have a nice school dinner there. Anyway, look, some of you giving your children sandwiches, are you being charged to do that? Look at this story again in this morning's Daily Mail. A growing number of state schools are charging pupils to eat their own packed lunch in the canteen. Teachers are warning. The so-called sandwich tax costs parents up to £2 a day, which supposedly goes towards cleaning and supervision in dining halls. School leaders said it was a sign of hard financial times their institutions face. But yesterday, the Department of Education slammed the practice as unacceptable and urged families to complain to the schools involved. That is outrageous, isn't it? Outrageous, that is. 26 out of the 2,221... I don't know how they get these numbers. There's so many people obsessed by numbers, aren't there? Certain managers in pubs. An assistant manager. How much have we taken? Who's teaching these people? Why are you so obsessed by money? How can people be so bloody obsessed by money? I tell you what does make me laugh. When these big companies who are paying, some of them under the minimum wage. We all know it goes on. We know it goes on. Some people being paid very small amounts of money. And then they go on the television and announce that they've made so many million pounds in profit and that we should all be proud of that. I don't think so, Sunshine. Don't think so. Anyway, 26th out of the 2,221 people, parents, 2,211, sorry, I got 10 wrong there, parents who answered the question about school food said their child had to pay to bring in a lunchbox this year, with about half charged between £1.50 and £2 a day. Gosh. For many parents who are, in the words of the Prime Minister, just about managing, says someone at a union's conference, their children may not qualify for a free school lunch. Parents are saying, I can't afford the price of a school lunch. I'll send my child in with sandwiches, only to find that they then have to pay between £1 and £2 a day just for the right of the child to sit in a cafeteria. Quite honestly, that defies common sense and reasonableness from our point of view. Well, that's disgusting, isn't it? Well, I've heard it all now. That's just ridiculous. So, I mean, I don't know if you've got children, but don't you think that is the most ridiculous thing? If you bring, if you give your children sandwiches to take into school, they then have to pay £1.50, £2 just to sit in the canteen. God's sake, man, it just gets worse and worse, doesn't it? It really does. Right, I've got two more stories for you this morning. This one's in The Sun. I don't know what's going on there. This is an article written by Lorraine Kelly. How are you now? Welcome to Lorraine Kelly in the morning. I can't do a Scottish accent. I'm not very good at that. Anyway, she writes, I'm baffled by the idea of turning your child into a trademark. Now, this has happened like Pepsi or Toilet Duck, but that's what the Beckhams have done to their 5-year-old daughter, Harper. Victoria, Vicky Beckham, has registered her small child's name for commercial use with intellectual property authorities in Britain and Europe. They actually must have sat down and agreed on a long list of products their daughter could promote, which we are being told includes, oddly, aromatherapy oils, wrapping paper, pencil sharpeners, golf umbrellas, and anti-wrinkle cream. Isn't that just... I mean, how much money do these people want, for Christ's sake? They're obsessed with money. Absolutely obsessed with money. And then they come on the telly, don't they? Oh, we're just a normal couple trying to look after our children. It's ridiculous. Remember, the child is just 5, says Lorraine Kelly. And even in the loopy la-la celebrity showbiz bubble, Harper is not someone who would encourage me to buy anti-aging products, a big lurid umbrella or a dolly now or ever. I wonder what the little girl's like, actually. Do you think she's a right little madam, like her mother? What do you reckon? According to the experts, this commercially minded action for such a child is unprecedented. But it's the world that brand Beckham have chosen to inhabit. So just keep an eye on that, boys. Make sure you don't buy anything with the word Harper on it, because you are helping these people to get even more richer. It's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. And people buy all the magazines with the pictures, OK Magazine and all that old crap, dear. Oh, look, what were that one Jordan's always in? Isn't about time she got married again, isn't it? So it must have been at least a year since she was last married, Katie Price. And have you seen her wedding pictures over the years? It was just soft porn or hard porn. It's hardcore porn. Awful. Ghastly. Why do you like it? Please tell me why you like all this stuff. Best magazine, Woman's Own, with all the pictures of the celebrities. Like that. I'm sorry, they just look like very strange people all the time. What the hell do you look like? And it's making them a fortune, only because you're buying the magazines. Oh, let's have a quick look at Katie Price today. Oh, look, she's in the sea in bra and knickers, and that's her wedding outfit. Do me a favour. Apparently, their sons, Brooklyn, Romeo and Cruz, are similarly registered. We're all told it's about protecting their future interests, as well as making sure they bring in wheelbarrows full of cash by exploiting the Beckham. I think it's just awful. Awful. Absolutely awful. So that's the story in this morning's Sun, boys and girls. OK, now what's the time? Yeah, I better wrap up now, boys and girls. Because it's getting to time where I've got to go and pick up my mate, and he gets very upset if I'm late. Just a moment now. Okie doke. This morning's birthdays then. Let's do today's birthdays. Happy birthday to the lovely Robert Houston. Hello, Robert. My lovely little friend. Doesn't say your age, dear. Where's your age? Happy birthday, Robert. Happy birthday to Regina Bobby, 45 years old today. Happy birthday, Regina. Kit Perleberg is 24 years old today. Carl McAleer is 42. You don't look 42, do you, lovey? Happy birthday, Carl. John Barry, our lovely John Barry, today is 85 years old today. He used to run a bar called Hollywood's in Gran Canaria. And he's retired now. And I've known him for many, many years. I've worked with him for a while in Reflex in Putney. That's that's got to be about 25 years ago or even more. And he's such a nice man. Happy birthday, John Barry, in Gran Canaria. Happy birthday, John. Happy birthday to Stella London, to Alexander McGregor. A lot of birthdays today. David Robbins. Hello, David. 29 years old today. Stanley Bear is 34 today. Joanne DeBell, happy birthday, Joanne. And Michael Varona is 45 years old today. Let's sing the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right, there we are. Happy birthday, boys and girls, on this Saturday. Okay, so this is the last show in the studio for a week or so. As I say, I'll be going up to my sister's for a little holiday. My mate's moving in here to look after the cat, which is all well and nice. Tonight I'll be doing a little bit of DJing and hosting cabaret at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. If you're going along to the karaoke on Monday this week, I will have Wayne will be hosting the karaoke at Central Station on Monday. And if you're going along to the quiz night on Wednesday at the King's Head Theatre Bar, Charlie, one of the barmen, Charlie, will be, and he's a little bit mouthy, the same as myself, you know. He'll be hosting the quiz for you on Wednesday night. Okay. Hope to see you as well that sometime this week. I'll probably be doing some recorded shows for you and shine you around my nephew's little workshop that that he runs now. Enjoy your Saturday, and I'll see you very soon. Thanks for watching and listening. Cheerio now.